Dear friends, welcome to another video. This is Nick from educate.tv and today we're going to learn how to play sounds with Arduino by building a micro piano. Without any further delay, let's get started. Playing back sound is great for adding audio feedback to our projects. So far we were using displays or LEDs in order to provide feedback to the user of the project. Today we will learn how to make sound with Arduino, and as you are going to find out, it is very easy. In order to demonstrate the sound capabilities of the Arduino Uno, I have built a simple project, a micro piano. Each time I press a button, Arduino makes a sound of a specific frequency for each button. The frequencies correspond to specific music notes. We have 7 buttons, so we can have 7 notes. So, let's try it. I am going to play a simple song using the available notes. Can you recognize which song is it? Let me try it once more. It's London Bridge is Falling Down, played on an Arduino Uno piano. Not bad for a simple project like this. Let's now see how to build this project. The parts needed for this project are these: an Arduino Uno, Nano, Mini or Mega. The Arduino Due won't work. A piezo buzzer or a small speaker. A 220 ohm resistor. 7 push buttons and a small breadboard. I also used this 3D printed Arduino and breadboard holder. I downloaded the file from Thingiverse and I printed it in my new 3D printer, the Wonhao i3 duplicator. You can find the link for this object in the description of the video. By the way, are you interested in a quick review of this 3D printer? Please vote for the review in the card here. If there is interest, I will be happy to post a video review of the printer on the channel in a few weeks. Back to the project now. The cost of the project is less than $10. You can find links for all the parts in the description of the video. Now, let's see how to connect all the parts together. At first, I'm going to connect the piezo buzzer. Note that there is a plus sign on the buzzer. That's the positive leg of the buzzer. The other leg is the negative. So, we connect the negative leg to the breadboard ground. We also connect one leg of each button to the breadboard ground. The next step is to connect the breadboard ground to Arduino ground. Next, we connect the positive leg of the buzzer via the 220 ohm resistor to digital pin 11. You can use any other PWM pin of the Arduino Uno if you like. PWM pins are marked with this symbol. Next, we connect the remaining leg of the buttons to digital pins from 10 to 4 on the Arduino Uno port. This button is attached to digital pin 10, this one to 9, 8 and so on. I am using the internal pull-up resistors of the Arduino board, so we don't need to connect any resistors to the buttons. If you want to use a speaker instead of the piezo buzzer, follow exactly the same procedure. Now we are ready to power up the project. As you can see, when we press the buttons, Arduino plays the corresponding notes. Great! Let's now see the software side of the project. First of all, we have to download the tone library. This library was developed a long time ago, so it will produce a compilation error if we try to use it with the newest Arduino IDE. All we have to do is to open the tone.cpp file and change line 35 of the file. Instead of wiring.h, we have to enter arduino.h. That's it. Now we can use the tone library. The tone library offers the tone function. It works like this. It takes 3 arguments, but the last one is optional. The first argument sets the pin to generate the tone on. The second argument sets the frequency of the tone. Lastly, the third optional argument sets the duration of the tone. If we don't use the third argument, we have to use the noTone function in order to stop the tone from playing. The cool thing about the tone function is that because it is using hardware timers, the sound can play in the background while we use Arduino to perform another task. That's a great feature for games. The code of the project is very simple. At first, we define the frequencies of the notes. In the setup function, I configure the button pins to use the internal pull-up resistors. I have made a special video on that subject. You can check it out by clicking on the card here. Next, at the loop function, we check if any button is pressed. If a button is pressed, we play the corresponding note using the tone function. When the button is released, we call the notTone function so that the Arduino stops playing the note. That's it. As always, you can find the code of the project in the description of the video. As you can see, we can make sounds with Arduino very easily using the tone function. I think this is a great fun project for beginners and very useful as well. I am going to use the tone function in some of my future projects. I will soon enough try to reproduce the snake game of the old Nokia phones using an Arduino Uno and the Nokia 5110 LCD display. I think that adding sounds to the game will make it even better. I would love to hear your feedback on this project. Do you plan to use sounds in your projects? If you have already used sounds, do you have any tricks to share with us? Please post your comments in the comment section below. Thanks! If this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribed. In this channel, I post videos about do-it-yourself projects every Saturday. I love making things and I believe that anyone can make things, anyone can become a maker. That's why I created this channel in order to share my knowledge with the community and learn from the community. I hope you will join us. Until next Saturday, watch, learn, build!